Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Alice, Polly Holiday, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Fly, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Randall.
What's going on out here? Is that it? Oh. Your light is
on. Beach State. Why isn't my light on? Oh, there it is.
It went off now, all right. People have been saying your light is off for years.
They've never. Right.
This light's always been on in my life.
Yeah.
Don't get maudlin.
A little something hatching here on the Match Game? Splendid. I greet you all and ask you in turn to greet our two players, Linda Thompson and Betty Pagani. Okay. Linda's our current champ chair. She's won $2,850. And I guess she's happy about that. Now she's being challenged by Betty Pagani, who's had both of her questions, right? And matched four of our celebrities. And that means you've got to match three to tie and four to win. You ready for that, ladies? All right, let's see how this turns out right after we see about this. Here we go. Okay. Let's see. Linda, this is yours.
Right.
You want B, right?
For sure.
Okay. You got B. The $6 million man's wife said, "My husband is made from elevator parts."
Don't say another word.
I guess we could quit right here, couldn't we? You're way ahead of me. My husband is made from elevator parts. His belly button says blank on it. Okay. Now, let's see. Everyone but Polly is a player here.
I've got it.
You got it there? All right. All set? All right. Now, let's come over here and get a response from Linda.
Could I hear the question?
Been here for 3 years, Linda. Here it is, Linda. The $6 million man's wife said, "My husband is made from elevator parts. His belly button says blank on it."
The only thing I can think of is D for down.
D for down. Don't they make you happy, honey?
Talk about ego.
Yes. She says D for down.
Well, I'd like to commend her on that because I said down.
See, now you see we're wrong. You see? Made that poor little girl feel bad and you were wrong. What do you say?
Where are those escapees from?
I don't know.
Press for down.
Press for down. That's two. Score is now 4-3. You need one more to tie and two more to win. Chuck?
Say that again. I love when you call me that.
What do you say, Chuck?
For all those rats out there who made fun of D for down.
There it is. Tie four. What are you flashing the light for? No, it's just not a win until I tell you it's a win. Now pay attention. Listen to what I'm saying here. Richard, she's looking for D for down.
No, I said push.
Push. You did.
Where's the little button?
That's
says
right.
Push.
The little button says push. Now, Fanny, she's looking D for down. She gets it. She wins.
Oh.
It's a tie if she doesn't.
Up.
Up. Well, we all have our ups and downs, don't we? Now the game ends in a tie. So when that happens, we have to blow a fuse here, turn the lights off. Zing. And push this button here. Reveal one tie-breaking question for each. The one who's matched the most will be the winner. Tie-breaking question. Betty, A or B?
I think I'll take A again, please.
A again. All right. A again. What she wants. Hey, listen.
Yeah.
Nobody in Fairyland knows this, but Snow White is really a dwarf in blank. Nobody in Fairyland knows this, but Snow White is really a dwarf in blank.
Did you see that? Can you make that, you little needlepoint devil?
That's a piece of needlepoint.
Somebody sent that to me.
Kidding.
It's a keychain.
Yeah, that's very attractive. Oh, look at this.
That's blank game on the...
Blank game, 76, M-A-T, well, it's the same number of blanks as there on the word match.
M-A-T-C-H.
Very
good.
All right, Betty Pagani. Nobody in Fairyland knows this, Betty. It'll be our little secret, right? But Snow White is really a dwarf in blank.
Oh, it's between two. I'll have to say a dwarf. The key word here is in and not on. In disguise.
In disguise. Snow White is really a dwarf in disguise. She said Snow White is a dwarf in disguise.
No, in drag.
In drag. All right. Disguise?
Drag.
No, well, no.
They're, to her, wouldn't
well,
it mean the same thing?
Probably not, no. What do you say?
I say, where's my drag?
That's two of those.
Of course, you're married in Argentina. I said El Drago.
El Drago. Yeah. Snow White is really a dwarf in drag. Polly, what do you say?
Drag.
Drag. So far, you got four of those, buddy, but you didn't say it. Let's see what Richard says.
Oh, isn't it a drag?
Yeah, it is. And you, Fanny.
Do you know what drag means?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Drag.
Okay.
Sorry.
Well, now that puts you in the catbird seat. All you got to do is match one to win. We'll see if that happens right after we see about this. Now we're ready to continue with the tiebreaker. Linda, this is yours. Remember, all you have to do is match one to win. The reporter said to the 139-year-old man, he said, "Tell me, old man, what is the secret of your long life?" And the old man said, "Help!" He said, "Simple. I blank 10 times every day." That is the secret of longevity. Simple young fella, I blank 10 times every day. That's good.
Take this to the cashier.
Okay. All right. Charles, why don't you just take that? All right. Linda Thompson, are you ready?
The
reporter said to the 139-year-old man, "Tell me, old man, what is the secret of your long life?" And the old man said, "Simple, young fella, I blank 10 times every day."
Made love.
Make love? That's how he lived to be 139, eh?
I doubt it. At 139, he breathed.
10 times a day. Okay, let's see what we have here. We have one make love answer, and she wins the game.
Before I show my answer, I would like to state
look
that this 139-year-old man had a very, very rich fantasy life, and he did say make love.
That wins the game. What the rest of you have?
Hold him up.
All right. There it is, all over there. There you go. Now, Benny Pagani, we'll have some gifts coming your way, and our thanks for being here on Match Game 77.
Enjoy
Betty
it.
Pagani. Goodbye, my dear. Here you are. One more time, Linda. Let's see how you do this time. Not too long ago, we had a bunch in here, and we said, you write down your best answer to this, blank pigs. Now, the answer they gave us most frequently, remember, gets you $500 if you match it. And for matching the second most frequently given answer, you got $250. And $100 for matching the third. And let's see what sort of assistance you'll get from our celebrities.
Brett.
The Bay of Pigs.
The Bay of Pigs is one.
Charles.
Three Little Pigs.
Okay.
And Richard.
Son of Three Little Pigs.
Now, wait a minute. An idea will come to you from above.
Something will...
Yeah. Something
no,
will come to you from...
Wait a minute. Now, there's something coming from above.
I'm trying to concentrate here.
Concentrate?
You know what I'll say? Guinea pigs.
Guinea pigs. Guinea pigs. So there they are, Linda. Bay of Pigs, Three Little Pigs, and Guinea Pigs. Do you want one of those, or do you want one of your own?
I want Three Little Pigs.
All right, let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin down at the bottom. Well, let's reveal the $100 response. Dirty Pigs.
Hey, why are you casting slurs
no,
on
that's
this panel?
You dirty rats, not... Johnny O's saying, you dirty pigs. It's not you dirty. It's you dirty rats. Yeah. Okay, let's see what's under the $250 number. Bay of Pigs, okay. Last chance for the Three Little Pigs. Slide it, please. Three Little Pigs. Got it. Very good. That was Charles' answer. Now you're going to play for 10 times that amount. Stand on the blue dot. Or $5,000. Remember now, to collect, you've got to match one celebrity exactly.
Charles.
Okay, Charles, get ready to write. Here we go. Good luck to you, Linda. It's worth $5,000. You ready, Charles?
Everybody running.
Here it is now. Blank tubes. T-U-B-E-S. Blank tubes. T-U-B-E-S. Write the word down, Charles. It may help give you an idea. T-U-B-E-S. Blank tubes. Now, here we go. Charles is finished. We ask you to give us an answer that matches his. We give you $5,000. Linda, blank tubes.
Test.
Test tubes. Okay. Good answer. Charles, she says test tubes will match you for $5,000. What do you say?
When you go to the beach, you the inner test tube.
Aha! She's a very happy lady, and while she's celebrating, you watch these messages. Here we are. Let's all welcome Don Smedley. Applause, applause, applause. Who is Don Smedley?
A very nervous person.
No. You're not nervous? Is he nervous?
Yes.
Hold his hand here.
All right.
Yes, hold him. Now, talk to me, Don.
Okay. I have a wonderful wife that's out in the audience right now.
Right.
Two boys.
A
little baby girl.
Yeah.
I'm a real estate broker, and I own a part interest in a rental company. And we love water sports and snow skiing.
Okay. Where do you do your snow skiing?
Well, Mammoth, and we have a cabin up in Big Bear Lake, Snow Summit.
And where do you live? You didn't tell us that.
Whittier.
All right, Don, good luck to you, sir. I'll push this button, reveal our first round questions, ask you to make a selection.
A.
A it is. He had that all prearranged in his mind. He's going to choose A. Here it is. Dull Ed has a tough time holding anyone's attention. He's so dull, when he talks to himself, he blanks. That's how dull he is. So dull, when he talks to himself, he blanks. Good. Very good, my dear.
Not up to your usual standards. That's right, that belly's
fine. What is that all about? You asked for a Kleenex, they threw the whole box over and tried to hit me in the blank.
Well,
okay.
That was part of the plan.
Dull Ed has a tough time, Don, holding anyone's attention. He's so dull when he talks to himself, he blanks.
Falls asleep.
He said falls asleep.
That's just like him, isn't it?
Yes.
Actually, before he falls asleep, he yawns.
He yawns a lot. You're drawing flies to your part of the stage.
I had 10 lines there, and I had to discard every one of them.
Well, the quick one is, he's an artist. He draws flies. Ring-a-ding-ding, rum-bong-guy.
That's beneath you, but I forgive you. No, this may be a match. Nods off.
Yes, it is. So that's one for Don Smedley.
I got it from Charles, actually, just watching him. Hello, darling.
You're so unaffected.
falls asleep.
Falls asleep. And now, my dear Polly, tell us what you have for Smedley. Smedley's the one over here in the wild suit.
He goes to sleep.
Goes to sleep. A little contribution for Smedley. Okay. Four for Smedley.
I said sleep.
She said sleep, yes.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry to interrupt you. Sleep there. Yes?
Yes, doesn't he have beautiful teeth?
Yes, he does.
I said nods off.
Nods off. Again, yes, that's two.
Take two sleep.
Well, you got five, John. That's very unusual and very good for a first-round question. Right, Linda?
Right.
Right. Now, this one's for you. Muggsy, he says, you know, when I was a kid, my neighborhood was tough. Let me tell you, instead of a basketball, we dribbled a blank down the street. That's how tough it was in my neighborhood. Instead of a basketball, we dribbled a blank down the street. A blank, yeah.
Yeah, I got that.
Hey, that fly is still flitting around your head there, Martin. I say, that fly is...
Tell me tracks on your foot.
The fly. Oh, boy, was we tough.
Well, I don't think we was that tough.
You rascal. Okay, Chuck. What do you say, Chuck?
Chuck's nodding off.
Gonna dribble you down the main aisle here in the studio if you don't give us an answer, buddy.
Tough boys would always beat me up in my neighborhood.
Yeah, well, I think I'm gonna do it to you right now. Gonna belt you right in the mouth.
Please, Jane.
Yeah. Hey, get rid of the flies or we're getting rid of you. Do you understand? Okay. All right. Linda Thompson, you ready?
I'm ready.
Muggsy said, when I was a kid, my neighbor was tough. Instead of a basketball, we dribbled a blank down the street.
A dog.
A dog? A dog.
Somewhere in this town, Betty White has fallen on the floor.
Betty White, yes. She just got a pain somewhere. A
she
terrible
just
thing.
Hired a hitman.
Yes.
What she said.
For Linda, what do you say?
I say he liked fruit. So he dribbled a cantaloupe. Anyone who likes fruit is all right with me. Yeah.
Let's hear it for Dick Martin.
There's a lot of guys down at the produce place that love me for that.
I don't care what he says. I'm crazy about it.
Yeah.
I said cannonball.
Cannonball. Good answer.
Why don't the rest of them join that
there
one
three
young
years,
man
yeah.
out there?
Chuck.
Hello, dear.
The loud voices, Jane, that get me so upset.
Are the voices coming back?
Well, they're very...
I love him.
The
no,
voice is coming
true.
Back to
I'm
you.
I'm not up to this.
Yeah.
Since the war and the tablets. Cannonball.
So, I got his answer.
We have two cannonballs here. Linda, so far we don't have a dog. And I'd be willing to bet anything that we're not going to get a dog there. But we have to carry on with the charade anyway there. Hello, Polly.
Well, I'm afraid I became awfully bloodthirsty.
Really?
Yes.
What'd you say?
Dribbled a head.
A head?
Really? Is she all right?
Well, she's, you know what? She's saving $50 in psychiatry fees. She's working out her unresolved hostilities right here on this stage.
A head.
Oh, isn't that something, Richard?
I think it's weird, weird.
What like made that. Her say it, I wonder?
I don't know.
I have no idea at all what made her say it. I have no idea what made me say dog.
Oh,
oh, dog!
Dribbling bloodhound.
Dribbling bloodhound. That's a well-known breed.
Dog?
He said dog.
Objects to magic.
It's a good thing no one took me up on the bet. All right. Fanny, what do you got?
Well... I thought it was really tough, see?
Yeah.
So I thought they dribbled a nun.
A nun? Yeah. 5-1 to score in round one. Now we got this message just for you. Hurry back here now.
Well,
next time we get together, these are the celebrities we will have for you.
Orson Bean, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Connie Stevens, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg.
You were dandy. I love you all. Goodbye. Thank you.
You did.
Where's the little button?
That's right. The little button says push. Now, Fanny, she's looking D for down. She gets it, she wins.
Oh.
It's a tie if she doesn't.
Up.
Up. Well, we all have our ups and downs, don't we? Now the game ends in a tie, so when that happens, we have to blow a fuse here, turn the lights off, zing, and push this button here. Reveal one tie-breaking question for each. The one who's matched the most will be the winner. Tie-breaking question. Betty, A or B?
I think I'll take A again, please.
A again. All right. A again. What she wants. Hey, listen. Nobody in Fairyland knows this, but Snow White is really a dwarf in blank.
Hello, darling.
Nobody in Fairyland knows this, but Snow White is really a dwarf in blank.
Did you see that? Can you make that, you little needlepoint devil?
That's a piece of needlepoint.
Somebody sent that to me.
Kidding.
It's a keychain.
Yeah, that's very attractive. Isn't that pretty? Look at this.
That's blank game on the
blank other. Game 76. M-A-T. Well, it's the same number of blanks as there on the word match.
M-A-T-C-H.
Very
right. Good.
All right, Betty Pagani. Nobody in Fairyland knows this, Betty. It'll be our little secret, right? But Snow White is really a dwarf in blank.
Oh, it's between two. I'll have to say a dwarf. The key word here is in and not on. In disguise.
In disguise. Snow White is really a dwarf in disguise. She said Snow White is a dwarf in disguise.
No, in drag.
In drag.
Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Alice, Polly Holiday. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Fly. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Randall.
What's going on out here? Is that it? Oh. Your light is on.
Long Beach State. Why isn't my light on? Oh, there it is.
It went off now, all right.
Thank you.
People have been saying your light is off for years.
They've never. Right.
This light's always been on in my life.
Yeah.
Oh. Don't get maudlin.
A little something hatching here on the match game? Splendid. I greet you all and ask you in turn to greet our two players, Linda Thompson and Betty Pagani. Okay. Linda's our current champ chair. She's won $2,850. And I guess she's happy about that. Now she's being challenged by Betty Pagani, who's had both of her questions, right? And matched four of our celebrities. And that means you've got to match three to tie and four to win. You ready for that, ladies? All right, let's see how this turns out right after we see about this. Here we go. Okay. Let's see. Linda, this is yours.
Right.
You want B, right?
For sure.
Okay. Charles, why don't you just take that? All right. Linda Thompson, are you ready?
I'm
a reporter
ready.
Said to the 139-year-old man, "Tell me, old man, what is the secret of your long life?" And the old man said, "Simple, young fella, I blank 10 times every day."
Made love.
Make love? That's how he lived to be 139, eh?
I doubt it. At 139, he breathed.
10 times a day. Okay, let's see what we have here. We have one make love answer, and she wins the game.
Before I show my answer, I would like to state that
look how
this 139-year-old man had a very, very rich fantasy life. And he did say, make love.
That wins the game. What the rest of you have?
Hold him up.
All right. There it is, all over there. There you go. Now, Betty Pagani, we'll have some gifts coming your way, and our thanks for being here on Match Game 77.
Enjoy
Betty
it.
Pagani.
Goodbye,
my dear. Here you are. One more time, Linda. Let's see how you do this time. Not too long ago, we had a bunch in here, and we said, you write down your best answer to this, blank pigs. Now, the answer they gave us most frequently, remember, gets you $500 if you match it. And for matching the second most frequently given answer, you got $250. And $100 for matching the third. And let's see what sort of assistance you'll get from our celebrities.
Brett.
The Bay of Pigs.
The Bay of Pigs is one.
Charles.
Three Little Pigs.
Okay. You got B. The $6 Million Man's Wife said, my husband is made from elevator parts.
Don't say another word.
I guess we could quit right here, couldn't we? You're way ahead of me. My husband is made from elevator parts. His belly button says blank on it. Okay. Now, let's see. Everyone but Polly is a player here.
I've got it.
You got it there? All right. All set? All right. Now, let's come over here and get a response from Linda.
Could I hear the question?
She's been here for 3 years, Linda. Here it is, Linda. The $6 Million Man's Wife said, my husband is made from elevator parts. His belly button says blank on it.
The only thing I can think of is D for down.
D for down. Don't they make you happy, honey?
Talk about ego.
Yeah. She says, D for down.
Well, I'd like to commend her on that because I said down.
See, now you see we're wrong. You see? Made that poor little girl feel bad and you were wrong. What do you say?
Where are those escapees from?
I don't know.
Press for down.
Press for down. That's two. Score is now 4-3. You need one more to tie and two more to win. Chuck?
Say that again. I love when you call me that.
What do you say, Chuck?
For all those rats out there who made fun of D for down.
There it is. High score. What are you flashing a light for? No, it's just not a win until I tell you it's a win. Now pay attention. Listen to what I'm saying here. Richard, she's looking for D for down.
No, I should.
All right. Disguise?
Drag.
No, well, no, they're...
Well, the same thing?
Probably not, no. What do you say?
I say, where's my drag?
That's two of those.
Of course, you're married in Argentina, and I said El Drago.
El Drago. Yeah. Snow White is really a dwarf in drag. Polly, what do you say?
Drag.
Drag. So far, you got four of those, buddy, but you didn't say it. Let's see what Richard says.
Oh, isn't it a drag?
Yeah, it is. And you, Fanny.
Do you know what drag means?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Drag.
Okay.
Sorry.
Well, now that puts you in the catbird seat. All you got to do is match one to win. We'll see if that happens right after we see about this. Now we're ready to continue with the tiebreaker. Linda, this is yours. Remember, all you have to do is match one to win. The reporter said to the 139-year-old man, he said, tell me, old man, what is the secret of your long life? And the old man said, help! He said, simple. I blank 10 times every day. That is the secret of longevity. Simple young fella, I blank 10 times every day. That's good.
Take this to the cashier.
Okay. All right.